Kami dah edarkan statement ini sekarang dalam bahasa Inggeris lah. So nomination day, this grace will start for the 14th general elections. The Coalition for Clean and Fair Elections, Bersih 2.0, condemns the manipulation and abuse of power by the Election Commission on the nomination day in several seats that comprise the integrity of the 14th general elections right from the beginning. It is a disgraceful start to the 14th general election where candidates are denied their constitutional rights to be nominated and voters denied their right to choices of candidates arbitrarily and unlawfully by the EC. These are the three cases. There are many cases, but the three main cases among the list of issues on nomination day that Bersih 2.0 finds to be in violation of free and fair elections. Number one, the disqualification of batu candidate, Saudara Tian, daripada PKR Pakatan Harapan, whereby the Elections Commission has clearly overstepped its boundaries in arbitrarily rejecting Tian Chua's nomination, especially since Tian's candidacy was accepted in the last general election. After the issue of RM2,000 penalty had been clarified in Kuala Lumpur High Court judgment in 2010, the judgment by the Hakim, and memang clearly it was discussed by the judge and he made the judgment and clearly said, maka dengan berpegang kepada keputusan dalam kes Mahkamah Agung di atas, saya berpuas hati dan berpendapat bahawa denda RM2 tidak menjadikan perayu hilang kelayakan beliau secara automatik kerana denda untuk menjadikan beliau hilang kelayakan adalah RM2,001 ke atas dan bukannya bermula daripada RM2. So this is the court judgment. It's very clear that in this long list of judgment ni, the judge already discuss this. And how can the returning officer go against the court? The second case is denying entry of rantau candidate Dr. Sri Ram from PKR PH into the nomination centre. Amino Agus Suyuk, the retaining officer of rantau, the EC and the police should not have denied the candidate entry on account that he failed to produce a pass issued by the EC, as the constitutional right to nomination of a citizen should be upheld over any technical formalities. Third case is the lack of transparency and due process in regards to the nomination of Ketari candidate, iaitu Datuk Lau Hoi Kiong from Gerakan Barisan Nasional. Bentong District Officer cum Returning Officer Datuk Azhar Arshad must answer for the lack of transparency and due process in regards to the identity card of BN candidate Datuk Lau Hoi Kiong. Datuk Azhar is accountable not only to the EC but to the people and voters of the country when it comes to transparency and clean elections. Why did he disallow the other party candidates to check the IC of Datuk Lau Hoi Kiong? If it is true that the address of the candidate has been changed on the electronic chip, this can be easily verified by displaying the information to the media and other stakeholders present at the nomination centre. Bersih 2.0 would also like to question the role of two officers from the National Registration Department, JPN, on their sudden presence at the nomination centre, as this is highly irregular behaviour. These attempts to compromise G14 by denying the right of candidates to contest fairly in the elections is also an assault on democracy and an insult to the right of voters. Their respective returning officers, the EC, the police and the two officials from the NRD must answer for their role in subverting clean, fair and free elections for the 40 million voters in Malaysia. Not the returning officer but the pegawai SPR yang datang untuk bercakap dengan Dr. Sidham. I think Dr. Sidham can ni. And this person yang datang malam, Dr. Sidham daripada datang untuk pusat penamaan calon tu, there have been so many reports that this person is actually a very staunch UMNO supporter, Hafizan Idris, and also the apa supporter for the a very strong person for the MB lah, picture dia dengan MB. So what has happened is very suddenly he has removed his Facebook page.
Ini gambar-gambar yang ditangkap oleh netizen. Tapi sekarang ni the impartiality of the SPR and their officers during penamaan calon pun is questionable with this kind of orang-orang yang berkepentingan yang juga boleh dilihat sebagai cuba untuk menghalang daripada proses penamaan calon Dr. Sri Ram. So kita dia dalam kenyataan media kita, kita ada detail dalam table ini, tapi kita mungkin kita jemput pada mereka lah untuk menambah pada detail.